Last chance, Pat. Tell me where it is.
I don't know what you're talking about, I swear.
Tell me where it is, or I'll waste you right here now!
You know, out of the long list of things I imagined happening today, I have to say this wasn't at the top. I mean, last night, I was on a date. And now, I'm sitting here in the middle of God knows where, with my best friend locked up in that car over there, and Alex Jordan, the wannabe bad boy here holding a gun in my face, threatening to kill me. Let me just go back to how yesterday was supposed to go.
Hey, Pat. Last week she posted a picture of her new Lexus hybrid. You're asking me, she should be buying you dinner.
Why do you think I'm dating her?
When you're at her house, taking her things, try to get her debit card. You have no idea how much money I can get from those numbers.
Ricky here was my partner in this money-making scheme. And it just so happened he had an IQ of 160. See, my parents are always snapping at me about getting a job and making good grades and stepping out into the real world. And they tell me I need to do all three at once, but they're just not creative like we are. It all started when I got my job at Publix. By job, I mean I would put on this uniform and act like I wasn't taking and replacing anything I wanted from the register. Once I told Ricky what I was doing, we made this deal where he'd get 65% of whatever I make, and in exchange, he'd help me with my schoolwork. Let's just say Ricky is a little more than a tutor. So we put our heads together, and we expanded our forms of business, and I started dating.
Hey guys, think I should spray paint this?
Who cares?
That's Sammy. He moved it from the Bronx after his family had to downsize, after having to bail him out from juvie for assault and battery. We figured he'd be good to keep around if anyone ever asked us too many questions.
This one doesn't look nearly as demented as the last one. Good luck.
I've been dating this girl Chloe for a couple of weeks now. She may have a couple of loose wires up there, but she is wealthy. And I'm sure she wouldn't mind if I took a couple of her things. I mean, that's why I'm here after all. I like dating rich girls, especially my last girlfriend, Hannah. But once I had gotten what I wanted and broken it off, she didn't take it very well. Okay, so I may have stolen her debit card, but she doesn't know. I mainly left her because she was so materialistic.
Hi, Pat.
Hi. Hannah, what are you doing here?
Oh, I'm sorry. Did I interrupt? Don't let me stop you from having a good time with Chloe, and then having an even better time with whatever you plan on stealing from her.
Are you serious? Is this really the way you want to handle this?
No. This is the best way to handle this.
How could you do this to me? I thought we had a fun time last night.
No. Oh. We did have fun. And I want to have fun tonight, too. It's just, someone has to learn that filling people's heads with lies won't get them what they want. Especially their ex-boyfriend back.
This isn't about getting you back! You stole from me! And I plan on saving Chloe the trouble before you do the same to her!
Oh, so you're blaming me now for stealing from you. I thought it was cheating. I guess you changed your mind after you changed your motive about wanting me back.
Then explain to me why my debit card and half my jewelry is missing!
Hannah's done her homework. And where'd you get that idea from?
I know how you and Ricky make your money!
You know what? If you're going to let her walk in here and talk to me like that while I'm about to take you out on a date, then don't bother. I have better things to do than listen to this nonsense.
Wait, no! Come back!
I thought leaving like that would leave Hannah with nothing else to do with the situation. She didn't have enough evidence to turn me in, but Hannah's not the kind of person to let things go. She's the kind of person that would call her other ex-boyfriend, Alex Jordan, and promise that she would get back together with him if he did this one huge favor for her.
account. There were plenty of exes she could have called, but Alex is known for taking things a little over the top. Sammy, get over here right now. Get in.
Tell me where it is, or I'll waste you right here now!
Alex, is this really the way you want to handle this?
Tell me where you're keeping Hannah's money, or I'll blow your freaking head off!
You know, Alex probably is stupid enough to kill someone he knows in cold blood, but something tells me he's bluffing. Then do it.
What?
You heard me.
I don't understand.
Pull the trigger and kill me. Watch me die right in front of you and see how far that gets you in this situation.
I'll do it!
Then by all means, kill me. Sammy, nice of you to join us.
Put the gun down.
Alex, Sammy here is one of my other friends. He's got a GPS on my phone and he followed it here. He's also got a 9mm pointed at the back of your skull, but you probably already figured that part out. Now, the way I see it, there's two ways of getting out of this. You can either walk away and none of us will get scheduled for funerals this week, or you can finish what you started. You can put one of those bullets into my head while Sammy here puts a whole magazine into yours before I even hit the ground. Now, in a situation like this, you have to ask yourself, am I really willing to do what I'm threatening? Or am I just some guy cluelessly waving a gun in another guy's face to impress a girl? Now, I know Hannah's into degenerates like you and I, but I think she's also into guys that have a pulse. Drop it. Go home, Alex. Oh, and Alex, next time you want someone to think you're going to shoot them, you might want to take the safety off first. You just painted your airsoft gun, didn't you?
Yeah.
Trying to trick me into doing battle, calling out fake up, wanna get me rattled, wanna pull me back behind the fence with the cat, building your lenses, digging your trenches, put me on the front line, leave me with a dumb mind with no defenses, but your defenses, if you can't stand to feel the pain, then you are senseless.